Thank you. Chag Sameach, and thank you so much for joining us. What a pleasure it is for these five congregations to come together to celebrate Shavuot, Chag Matan Torateinu, the celebration of our receiving of Torah. Our theme tonight is Shuvi Nafshi, the return to our soul, a return to stillness, a return to love, a return to light, a return to community.
May I be empty and open to receive the light. May I be empty and open to receive. May I be full and open to receive the light. May I be full and open to receive. May I be empty and open to receive the light. May I be empty and open to receive. May I be full and open to receive the light. May I be full and open to receive. May I be empty and open to receive.
One could argue that the journey from Passover to Shavuot is all about love. On Passover, we celebrate the idea that God brought us out of Egypt because God loved us. We read the Song of Songs to think about the relationship between God and the Jewish people as that of lovers in a garden. Tonight, on Shavuot, we read of a different kind of a love between Ruth and Naomi. A love that is inside of us as we received Torah. Our people's story is indeed about a love between each one of us and the world, between each one of us and the people we connect with, between each one of us and God. May we return to the love we found as we came out of Egypt. May we return to the love we experienced when we received the Torah on Mount Sinai.
Oh, Tanu,
Beit Yisrael,
Amcha.
In science, it's the Big Bang. That's how this all began. In the Jewish imagination and the biblical tradition and the rabbinic tradition, on top of that, it's the big whisper, perhaps, that this all came into being, not with a sound louder than you can imagine, but a sound softer. God creates the world with speech, and with the type of speech that begins with an aleph, amar. God kept amaring and amaring and amaring, and there was the earth, and there were the seas, and eventually there was us. And at Sinai, we capitulated that. When we were created as a people, there are descriptions in the book of Exodus of tremendous thunder from the heavens. But revelation itself, according to one Midrashic tradition, was as unloud as you can possibly fathom. In fact, there are some traditions that say that the only thing that God actually said in revelation was the first letter of the first word, of the first commandment, Anochi Adonai Elohecha, I am the Lord your God. And what's the first letter of that first word, of that first commandment? An aleph. And what sound does it make without a vowel? None. Revelation came through stillness. Our experience of it was to respond triumphantly, but we experienced it in the moment, perhaps as a great and profound silent stillness. On Shavuot, as we stand again at Sinai, we invite ourselves to return to stillness, to the power of what can be created, not only when there's noise, but when there's the absence of it. When we open our mouths to sing, sometimes that is what fills the world with joy. And when we close our eyes and wait and pause, sometimes there can be an even greater revelation in that moment. On this Shavuot, let us return to silence. Let us return to Aleph. Let us return to stillness.
May I be safe. May I be free. May I find this space to just be. Can you hear a tone? May I find my way back home? Can you hear a tone? Can you hear a tone? May I find my way back home? May you be safe. May we be saved. us on? Can you hear us on? May we find our way back home. Can you hear us on? Can you hear us on? May we find our way back home.
Can you hear us on?
Can you hear us on? May we find our way back home.
When Moses came down the mountain with the Ten Commandments, it says, Karan Or Panav, that his face was radiant. And the rabbis wonder, what was the source of this radiance? Why was light coming forth from his face? Most of them say it was because Moses had an opportunity to be intimate with God. But there's one story that says that what was so special was that as Moses was finishing to write the Torah with quill and ink, that at the very end there was a little bit of ink left over, and he accidentally touched the quill to his forehead, and some of the ink went on his face. And as a result of that, he shone bright. The story is trying to teach us that when we can be intimate with Torah, when we allow it to wash over us, to touch us, we can shine. We are supposed to be a light unto the nations. So let us get close to Torah. Let it touch us so we can shine bright.
Ain't the cat and all.
Jewish calendar allows us to consistently be reminded of important lessons. You see, we go through our day-to-day life, our mundane activities, and we forget these basic truths that are so important. On Shavuot, one of the ideas that we're taught is the basic truth of Torah, the notion of love. You see, our text begins by explaining that we all come from a common ancestor, from Adam and Eve. And on that same note, the idea that we are all made B'Tselem Elohim, in the image of the divine. And that idea that we're made in the image of the divine means that we have an obligation to love all people. How can you not love something made in the image of the divine? Now, that is an incredibly difficult pill to swallow. Sometimes people hurt you. They upset you. They say mean things, divisive things. They do things intentionally to shake things up. It's even hard for rabbis. Believe me, we don't always like everyone, but we have to love everyone. Rabbi Prince said in a famous speech, to be a rabbi, you have to love people. You don't have to like people. It says that love thy neighbor as thyself. It says nothing about liking thy neighbor at all. So Rabbi Prince chose to love all people because that's exactly what he assumed that God intended with the notion of B'Tselem Elohim. So this Shavuot, return to that basic idea. Return to a difficult one at that, to love all people. Love all of God's creation. Love the notion of humanity.
Let there be love and understanding among us. Let peace and friendship be our shelter from life's storm. Let there be love and understanding among us. Let peace and friendship be our shelter from life's storms. Hashkiveinu Adonai Eloheinu. Hashkiveinu l'shalom. V'ha'amidenu shomreinu l'chayim. Ufros aleinu sukkat shlomecha. Hashkiveinu,
Hashkiveinu
Adonai.
Hashkiveinu
l'shalom. Hashkiveinu Adonai Eloheinu. Hashkiveinu l'shalom. Let there be love and understand. Friendship be our shelter from life's storms. Let there be love and understanding among us. Let peace and friendship be our shelter from life's storms.
Shuvi Nafshi. A return to our own soul often happens most effectively through relationships with other souls, with other people. The story of Ruth and Naomi is exactly a story of that, a return to soul. And they did it returning to someone who was identified as other, as foreign, as too different to be someone we could actually belong to. Their story starts in loss and grief and death, with the death of Naomi's sons and her husband, the death of Ruth's husband, Naomi's son. We've come through a time of great loss, a lot of grief, a lot of death, a lot of fear. Naomi and Ruth choose each other in that time of loss and grief, and they choose each other to start moving forward out of that. Across their differences, across being other, they come together and become family. This Shavuot, this time of receiving Torah, this time of returning to soul, let us see across our differences in ways that mean real risk for us. May we also come into relationship with those parts of ourselves that we've split off and made other out of shame or fear or guilt. This is the way we will come to wholeness. This is the way we will come into what will move us forward. In that moving forward, Ruth and Naomi become each an ancestress of Mashiach, of the Messiah. For us, the Messianic age. This is what it will take. To birth a redemptive future means we must be able to see the parts of ourselves and of others that we have been estranged from in ways that keep us divided and fearful and separate. May this Shavuot be a time that we begin to figure out how we can reconfigure what family means, that we can look into relationships that will help us heal and grow, and that we can, most importantly, do the work of finding those parts of ourselves we need to reclaim so that we can move forward to Yemei HaMashiach, the Messianic Age.
Shalem Adonai polech utehim askurtech shlemach meim Adonai Elohei Yisrael hashebat lachasot tachat knafah Shalem Adonai polech utehim maskurtech shlema meim Adonai Elohei Yisrael hashebat lachasot tachat knafav. May God repay your actions and may your reward be complete from God. Elohei Israel, to whom you came for shelter under God's wings. Vitzel k'nafecha tastirenu Shomrenu umatzilenu ata uvitzel k'nafecha tastirenu ki el melech hanun v'rachum ata ushmor tzeitenu uvoenu l'chaim. Adonai Elohei Israel
Ashebat lachasot tachat knafa. Yishalem Adonai kolech. Uteim askuretech shlema. Ne'im Adonai Elohei Yisrael. Ashebat lachasot.
Immediately before we say the Shema prayer, we celebrate God's love for the Jewish people, and the symbol of that gift of love is Torah, wisdom, the learning of 3,000 years. And included in that prayer in the morning service, we ask God to bring the Jewish people together from the four corners of the world. V'havi'enu l'shalom me'arba kanfot ha'aretz. There is a return to love that we celebrate when we come together as community, when we experience what it is to really be with one another again.
Ahuv yakar zivi shonim Higia et hanitzanim Ahuvi kumalach lirot baganim Lirkot shoshanim Morim kinamonim Ahuvi kida vikanim Avru avonim Zachra levanim Al kol ha'emunim Ahuvi nedadu mikinim Ahuvi edom a
There's actually something that God created before heaven and earth, even though that is the first line of the Torah. One Midrash talks about the fact that God wrapped God's self in a garment of light. And it was only after wrapping God's self in that light that God could move forward creating heaven and then earth. This has been a year where, unfortunately, we've been wrapped in sorrow and pain and depression and fear and anxiety. Tonight with Shavuot, when we remember that Torah, we're supposed to imagine ourselves being wrapped in a garment of light, that we are surrounding ourselves with the lessons, the stories, the beauty, the intimacy, the opportunity that comes with Torah, that when we can wrap ourselves in the light of Torah, we can enter a new phase, not just individually, but we as a society, collectively, we can begin to wrap one another in that essence, in that radiance, in that love.
Oh,
According to the Midrash Pesichta Rav Kahana, the first word of the Ten Commandments, Anochi, was heard by the Israelites in their native tongue, Egyptian. And they heard the word Anoch, which means love and endearment. At that moment, we understood God's love. In Shemot Rabbah, we read, said Rabbi Abahu in the name of Rabbi Yochanan, when the Blessed One gave the Torah, no bird chirped, no fowl fluttered, no ox lowed. The angels did not fly. The seraphim did not utter the kedusha. The sea did not roar. The creatures did not speak. The universe was silent and mute. There, we found God's stillness. Isaiah tells us that God said, quote, I, Adonai, in loving kindness have summoned you. And I have grasped you by the hand. I created you and appointed you a covenant people, a light unto the nations. At that moment, we felt God's light. May we, as we go forth, live with the love, stillness, and light that God has shown us, and direct ourselves towards the betterment of the world. May we, in partnership with God and each other, commit ourselves to shine with the light of Torah, to live with love in our hearts, and to renew ourselves through stillness and peace.
Much wisdom have I learned from my teachers, more have I learned from my friends.
From my students, have I learned the most of all.
Harpei lamadati me rabotai, umecha me rayote. Umi tal mi dai, yoter mi kula. Turn.
is in it. Everything is in it. Turn it and turn it around.
Turn it and turn it and turn it. Turn it and turn it around. Everything is in it. Everything is in it. Turn it and turn it around.
We hope you have enjoyed the music and the spirit, the sounds and the silence of tonight's presentation. And we invite you, we beg you to linger either on campus at Temple Beth Am or throughout the digital world as we continue to study Torah all night, earning revelation and celebrating Shavuot together. Chag Sameach.
Much wisdom have I learned from my teachers. More have I learned from my friends.
From my students, have I learned the most of all.
Harpei lamadati me rabotai, umechaverai yoter me rabotai, umitalmidai yoter mikula, yoter mikula.
Everything is in it. Everything is in it.